Black holes making sounds. Distant galaxies sending radio signals. My tummy rumbling with hunger. These are just some of the curious sounds and stuff scientists have discovered in outer space. Well, maybe not my tummy. But there are many other mind-boggling facts to learn, starting with… Saturn's rings are very thin compared to its size. If you had a scale model of the planet that was 3 feet wide, the rings would be 10,000 times thinner than a razor blade. Mercury is a few billion years old. In 2016, scientists discovered some abnormalities on the planet's surface, showing that it's getting smaller. After more research, they found out that Mercury hasn't finished cooling down yet. Even though Venus is the hottest planet in our solar system, it still has snow. But it's not what you expect. It snows metals and rains acid. Not a great vacation spot. A day on Uranus lasts 17 hours, 14 minutes, and 24 seconds. But get this, the planet has a tilt of around 98 degrees, and that makes a season on the gas giant last 21 Earth years. Mars has two moons, Phobos and Deimos. In the next 30 to 50 million years, Mars' gravitational forces will tear Phobos apart, and it will likely result in the formation of a ring around the planet. I won't be around then. A light year is the unit of distance covered by light in a single year. Light moves a little more than 186,000 miles per second. So one light year is almost 6 trillion miles. Which reminds me, our Milky Way is 105,700 light years wide. Really, trust me. There's a whole lot of water floating in space. Astronomers discovered a huge vapor cloud that's 140 trillion times the mass of the Earth's ocean water. But don't worry, it's 12 billion light-years away, so we won't drown in that stuff anytime soon. Saturn's rings weren't discovered all at once. It happened gradually, and they were named alphabetically based on the time scientists found them. They go like this: D, C, B, A, F, G, E. Which, of course, spells Dikbafki. There's a giant red spot on Jupiter that's bigger than Earth. Astronomers confirm that it's a perpetual storm that has been going on for centuries. Color me weightless. Astronauts only wear orange spacesuits during launch, landing, or when they're in the spaceship for survival and rescue purposes. Their white suits are equipped differently to help them survive in outer space. The closest neighbor to our Milky Way is the Andromeda Galaxy. It's 2.5 million light-years away, and you can see it on a clear night with an unaided eye. And by the way, in a little more than 4 billion years, our galaxy will collide with the Andromeda Galaxy. According to some predictions, the galaxies won't survive, but our solar system will. Place your bets! It takes 243 Earth days for Venus to complete a rotation around its axis, but it takes 225 Earth days for the planet to orbit the Sun. That means a day on Venus is longer than a year. Now, we always see the same side of the Moon no matter where we are on Earth. That's because the Moon rotates around the Earth at the same speed it rotates around its own axis. In 1999, there was a big oops in space. NASA lost a Mars orbiter because half of the engineers were doing the metric system and the other half were doing their calculations using the imperial system. Now, it's impossible to see a black hole. What telescopes pieced together were the effects of a black hole on its surrounding area. For example, when a star is close to it, we can see it being ripped apart. When astronauts go into space, they can grow 3% taller. The lack of gravity causes their spines to expand, but that doesn't last long. When they get back to Earth and adjust to the gravity, they shrink back. NASA has an official Office of Planetary Protection just in case life is discovered on other planets. There's a supermassive black hole 250 million light-years away that hums the deepest sound ever detected from any object in the universe. It's 57 octaves lower than the Middle Sea. That's 1 quadrillion times deeper than what we can hear. The International Space Station is the largest single human-made structure to have entered space. It weighs 925,000 pounds, and it's the size of an American football field. Now, a spacesuit costs about 12 million bucks. It protects astronauts from the sun, space dust that travels faster than the speed of sound, and extreme weather conditions. Their helmets even have Velcro patches to help them when they itch. The Moon is 400 times smaller than the Sun, and the Earth is 400 times further from the Moon than the Sun. That's why they appear to be the same size during an eclipse. There's a star 50 light-years away from Earth, 90% of whose mass crystallizes, and the interior is made of carbon. That means it's the biggest diamond ever found. Oh, and they named it Lucy. You know, Lucy in the sky with… never mind. There are Martian rocks on Earth. Small space rocks enter the Earth's atmosphere all the time. We call them meteorites. A total of 61,000 such stones were found on Earth, and 224 of them came from Mars. In 2011, scientists discovered a small Martian rock that's a few billion years old. There are 181 moons in our solar system orbiting planets, yet two of those planets don't have any. That's Venus and Mercury. The only two dwarf planets that don't have natural satellites are Ceres and Makemake. On Earth, sound travels to our ears through vibrating air molecules, but in space, the empty areas between stars and planets are, well, molecule-less. So the sound can't travel, and we can't hear anything out there. Really? Hey, next time you're in space, outside the ship, take your helmet off and listen. On second thought. At 4.6 billion years old, the Sun is considered a middle-aged star. It's halfway through its life, and it's known as a yellow dwarf. When it becomes a senior and burns up all its fuel, it will swell into a red giant and swallow Mercury, Venus, and probably Earth. But after that, it will shrink down and become a white dwarf. How rude. There's something in mathematics that's opposite of what a black hole represents. It's called a white hole. Get it? Nothing can enter it from the outside, and only light and matter can get out of it. We've mapped 100% of the Moon's surface and 99% of the surface of Mars, but we've barely studied 5% of the Earth's oceanic floor. It takes 1.3 seconds for the moonlight to reach the Earth, and it travels a distance of 239,000 miles. There are 5 retroreflectors on the Moon's surface that mirror the light back to the source. So, if you shoot at the Moon with powerful lasers, the light will come back in 1.3 seconds. There are 88 recognized star constellations in the Earth's night sky, and we can get a glimpse from the northern and southern hemisphere. Decades ago, astronomers believed that Mercury didn't rotate around its axis, and the same side of the planet always faced the Sun. It wasn't until 1965 when they discovered that it does actually rotate, but at a snail's pace. One rotation takes 57 Earth days. Our Moon is moving around 1 inch away from Earth every year. That causes the Earth's rotation to slow down, too. The most productive scientific instrument ever created is the Hubble Space Telescope. It's been in operation for more than 25 years, and astronomers published more than 15,000 scientific papers using it. The distance between the Sun and the Earth identifies as an astronomical unit. It's exactly 95 million miles, or 1 AU. In 2016, a telescope picked up radio waves from a dwarf galaxy that's 3 billion light-years away from us. When the signal started their journey, Earth was just beginning to form its continents. The International Space Station circles our planet every 92 minutes. It orbits the Earth at 17,500 miles per hour. That's nearly 5 miles per second. There is something called Space Surveillance Network that keeps track of how much space junk orbits the Earth and who's responsible for it. Now, there are more than 309,000 rocket parts and inactive satellites orbiting the Earth. Not counting the working satellites and stuff. Kinda getting crowded up there. There's a planet 64.5 light-years away from our solar system with a bright blue color and some shady weather. The winds there travel at 5,400 miles per hour and it rains glass. No thanks. I'd rather go to Hawaii. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right. And remember, stay on the bright side of life.